After a day of rest and relaxation, the Ice Hogs are ready to take on the Muskegon Fury in a game featuring the top two teams in the league at that time. The mood is light as the boys board the bus for the 10-minute ride to the rink. Steve Martinson likes to have his team at the rink 2 hours before the puck drops, even if he has to drive them there himself. A late arriving bus driver does not mix well with a punctual head coach, but it only sets the team back just a few minutes. Inside the LC Walker Arena, Rockford settles into their locker room. When goalie Michelle Robinson finds his gear next to Eric LaBelle's and Steve Pelletier's, he creates a makeshift sign out of tape that reads, "The French Connection." This is the time when players order their bus food for the trip back to Rockford, and others go through the updated league statistics. For Coach Martinson, this is pretty much all he does to prepare for tonight's game.
We'll do certain things for certain penalty kills, certain different types of breakouts, different breakouts if we're going against a team that traps. But the team is conditioned, so they know if we're doing, you know, it's just we're trap breakout. And you might talk about, you know, like when you play Muskegon, they like to try to get the puck to Robin Bouchard in the slot. You talk about some positional play where you have to be and remind guys. But it's funny that even one-on-one stuff, you'll see somebody make a mistake. And you can't cover everything all the time. I mean, players would never listen to you. You just kind of sometimes if something sneaks up, you got to address it. But I believe in, you know, playing a simple game and keeping it simple.
While Coach Martinson might be oversimplifying things a bit, there is no question about his coaching record. Simply put, Martinson is a winner. When he was hired to dig the Ice Hogs out of the bottom of the UHL, Rockford had four losing seasons and one season when they finished one game above 500. Steve Martinson, by comparison, had been a head coach for the San Diego Gulls in the East Coast and West Coast Hockey Leagues, a team he won five championships with in 8 years. In fact, he has never had a team finish the season with more than 22 losses. Steve Martinson hates losing. He is passionate about winning. And when things don't go his way, he lets everyone know about it, as the Muskegon Fury would soon find out. The players return to the locker room after the pregame skate and wait for Coach Martinson to address the team.
They're short a couple of their regulars. Good thing about playing tonight is we get to get last night out of our minds for the Super Bowl with a good win tonight, eh? Good f***ing win. Gotta put our pressures on ourselves to, you know, to get our lines going, eh? Gotta have everybody contributing again. That's our secret to success. Everybody's f***ing going. We gotta make sure we got smart penalties, too. We take a penalty, don't take a f***ing bad penalty tonight. And let's make sure we're all over Bouchard. We're hitting them a lot.
The locker room has a very different mood tonight than what it did last night in Motor City. You could hear a pin drop in the dark, cramped locker room, and the boys seem especially focused for this game. Perhaps because they know what to expect from the Fury tonight.
Because they're dirty, especially at home. They're a totally different team at home and on the road. You know, I don't think they threw one body check in our rink, and then we went up to their rink, and they're all 6'2", 400 pounds, and they're playing like heroes, you know? So.
A crowd of 3,200 has made their way to their seats, and the puck drops. Both teams badly want this win, and it doesn't take long before Muskegon sets the tone for the first period.
The f*** is that? Who was that, 44? Hey, Jack, that's a major penalty. You missed a really bad cross check to the face. Is that his blood? Always from behind. Maltz, don't start a fight, but I want to put a little scare into this guy. You go f***ing center. That's what I f***ing thought! Miguel, you wanna be, don't be so low. Don't be so low. Don't let him just go back and forth so easy to the point. Move for each other, boys. Move. Gotta have your sticks on the ice, guys. Killing penalties, get your sticks in the passing lane. Brood, you've got the box.
Tempers reached the boiling point when Muskegon's David Ambler and Rockford's Eric LaBelle dropped the gloves. And Coach Martinson wants the linesmen to stay out of their way.
Stay out of there! Stay out!
Adding to his frustration was this apparent goal scored by Brent Sullivan, which left Coach Martinson speechless.
There is no goal for Puck Muskegon.
But when Rockford's Olivier Proulx was taken down with no penalty called,
get it! What the f*** is that? Yeah, the next one!
And Alex Kim drawing a tripping minor on this play, Martinson had seen enough.
Hey, where's Duke? JF, what about the one he called? He didn't call. What was the difference? On Proulx, what was the f***ing difference? Let's go. I'm giving Proulx and Dufour. Guys f***ing pulls down Proulx right before that. They blast you in the paper, and this is what you do.
And referee Jack McCoy had heard enough.
What a f***ing job.
The period ends with neither team getting on the scoreboard. As the teams leave the ice, Martinson has words for Muskegon's Robin Bouchard.
F***ing peacock.
And Bouchard has words for the Ice Hogs. It was a frustrating first period for Rockford, and in the locker room, Coach Martinson's words cut right to the bone.
Can tighten up our sticks and go to f***ing war with these f***ing guys. Can use your f***ing strength, and I mean it to the f***ing man. I'll be watching everybody tonight. Finish your f***ing checks. I'm not telling anybody to f***ing cross-check guys, but finish your f***ing checks and play f***ing tough. That is not a f***ing tough team.
The puck drops to start the second frame. Rockford comes out swinging, while Muskegon comes out scoring.
Cross it, high slot, big flash, save, rebound, there's a backhander goal by Nelson. Now we have a penalty coming up on Rockford. There's a rebound, loose in front line, another shot goal.
Rockford is now down 2-0 halfway through the game, and a frustrated Martinson has some words for Muskegon's coach Todd Nelson.
Quite a different team you gotta get home. I'd be embarrassed if I was you. Can shove it up their f***ing ass.
When another obvious penalty is not called by referee Jack McCoy.
What is that? You saw that! That's a major f***ing penalty!
Last night, Muskegon hosted Fort Wayne in a game that saw referee Jack McCoy give the Fury only two power plays. McCoy was severely criticized in the Muskegon newspaper, and before this game is over, McCoy will give Muskegon 11 power play opportunities, which will be a new team record, and that's not sitting well with Martinson.
Sometimes you might be able to get a call because you convince them to see it your way. They're human, they make mistakes, and I know that they can be both make up calls and stick it to you when they want to, and you know, it's just like the, you know, like anybody in any business, just because they're in a position of authority doesn't mean that they're gonna always be fair, and they're not gonna let grudges and mistakes and things influence them and, you know, pass. So you try to get them to you know, to be honest.
With the calls not going Rockford's way, the team turns their attention to putting some points on the board, and before the second period ends, Chris Gobert cuts into the Muskegon lead.
Threw it to the point, Maltz with it. Hellfire went in front, that tipped it up for a rebound, let's go! Gobert hammered it home! Now Lawmaster will give Gobert a little shove, but the Hogs cut the lead in half to 2-1 with a goal by Chris Gobert.
Unfortunately for the Ice Hogs, it would be the closest they would get to the Fury tonight.
Mark behind the Rockford, Cage to the backhand, loose puck down there again. Bouchard, another shot, there's a goal! Bouchard will get it, and it's 3-1. Here's Muskegon, 2-on-1. Bouchard and Lawmaster. Bouchard shot, saved by Robinson. Now it's batted in, that's a goal. Batted out of midair, and it's 4-1.
With his team down 4-1 late in the game, there wasn't much else Martinson could say. The numbers spoke for themselves. Rockford collected 80 penalty minutes and gave the Fury, the best team in the league when it comes to the man advantage, 11 power play opportunities.
It was one of the worst games that I'd ever played in 10 years, and it just Bush League. And I wasn't going to tell my guys to now play Bush League. I'm not going to have our guys. I mean, I take pride in having an honest, straight-up team, you know, typically physical teams. But this year I think we have our physical guys, but we also have a lot of team speed. I think we're now well-known for speed, but we've got three of the toughest guys in the league that if you want to, you know, try to match up with us, you know, we can drop the gloves with the best of them. But I got a kick out of, you know, teams that play a little rougher at home than they do on the road.